Well, good evening and welcome to another Spirit Life broadcast. I'm Pastor Ken, and we're so glad that you've joined in with us this Wednesday evening. Come on, let's say Romans 8:2 together. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made you and I free from the law of sin and death. You know, the Word of God talks about spirit life, abundant life, Zoe life, eternal life, the God kind of life. It's the life that Jesus died for, and it's the life that we're always striving for. And the law of life that's in the Word of God in Christ Jesus makes you and I free from the domination of the law of sin and death. Now, we understand that the law of sin and death came when Adam transgressed in the garden. Sin came into the world, and death by sin. And so all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But amen, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the light. And he is the mediator between God and mankind. We know there's only one God and one mediator between God and man. Amen. And that's the God-man, Christ Jesus. And he died for our sins according to the scriptures, that we might have part and parcel in the kingdom of Almighty God. So we're going to start off, as we always do, with partaking of the Lord's Supper tonight. We call it the meal that heals. Amen. The bread that represents the broken body of Jesus Christ. Isaiah put it this way: he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was laid upon him, and with his stripes, you and I were completely healed. 1 Peter 2:24 says, who his own body bore our sins in his own body on the tree, whom his own self bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we being dead to sins would live unto righteousness, by whose stripes we were healed. Isaiah says we are healed. Peter says we were healed. Amen. And so we understand that God is trying to get us to put this work of redemption together and have a complete understanding that right now you and I are healed by the Word of God. Jesus is the living Word. Amen. And he's given us the Bible, which is the written word, the Logos, amen. And he uses the Logos to minister to us the Rhema word, the spoken word. And he speaks to us by way of his Spirit, who is dwelling in our spirits, amen. That's the way God speaks to his people. I believe it's Proverbs 20 and verse 27. It says that the spirit of man is the candle of the Lord that searches all the inward parts of the belly. So God is going to minister to you in spirit. John 4:24, God is a spirit. And they that worship him, they that contact him, amen, they that communicate with him, amen, must worship him in spirit and in truth. And so we're so glad that we understand man being a spirit being, he takes the Word of God, which is spirit life. He puts the Word of God, he feeds on the Word of God, and that spirit life, amen, begins to minister to our reborn spirit, amen. And then we're led by the Spirit of God. We make communication and contact with the living God through the Word of God. And so the Word of God says, by the stripes of Jesus, you and I were healed. We are healed. And so we're standing on the Word of God tonight, and we are enjoying the ordinance of God. And Jesus told his disciples at the Last Supper, he said, I'll not eat and drink with you again until I do it new in the kingdom of God. And soon and very soon, we're going to see the King, and we're going to sit down at the great marriage feast of the Lamb. Amen. And all the saints of the ages are going to sit with Jesus. Amen. And eat with him. And we are so looking forward to that. So the word of God says, occupy. Jesus said, occupy until I'm done. Be about the Father's business. So let's commune tonight in spirit and in truth. The bread, and then, of course, the cup. Praise the Lord. You know, it says in Matthew chapter 6, Matthew chapter 6 and verse 11, Jesus is teaching his disciples to pray, and he says, give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread. And then in Matthew chapter 15, Jesus tells the Syrophoenician woman, he says in verse 26, it's not meat, or it's not feet, it's not fit, it's not right to take the children's bread and to cast it to the dogs. And so we see, as we compare scripture with scripture, that healing is for the children. It's the children's bread. Amen. And bread and water, especially back in that day, were two main things that could keep a man alive. And so Jesus said, let it be a daily prayer that your bread would be taken care of. And so we understand that healing is the children's bread, and God wants us to feast on the Word of God, make contact with the Word of God, so that that bread can be realized, and so that bread can be manifesting in the temples of the Lord, which are our bodies. Our bodies are his temple, and he wants the temple to be every whit whole. He wants the temple to be right. Amen. Because he has a plan for all of us. He has a purpose for all of us. He has destiny for all of us. And the best way to encounter and to operate in the will of God is to operate with a body that's strong and fit and able to endure the rigors of the temptations that we encounter, the diverse temptations that we encounter on this pilgrimage that we're on in honor of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and Abba Father. And so I just want to go over some daily things that we need to incorporate if we're going to walk in the healing of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the healing that he paid for us to have. Number one, remember this, it's God's will to heal because it's part of his redemptive plan. However, one must receive a fresh baptism in the practical aspects of abiding in the Word. And I said all that to say that healing belongs to us, but the healer is Jesus Christ. The word spoken in the Old Testament was by the prophets. And he said in Psalms 107:20, he sent his word by the prophets, and it healed them and delivered them from their destructions. But in the New Testament, we understand that the word, the living word, is Jesus Christ. John said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Matthew 8:17 talks about that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. 1 Peter 2:24, who his own self bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that you and I, being dead to sins, will live unto righteousness, by whose stripes we are healed. And of course, Isaiah says, he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. With his stripes we are healed. And John 15:7, a very important, a very intricate part of this work of healing, says, if ye abide in me and my words abide in you, then you can ask for whatever you will, and it'll be done unto you. Meaning that there's something about the heart of man engaging the word of God that produces the faith life. And the faith life is what God demands on our part. Without faith, it's impossible to please him. But faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So as we are feeding on the word of God, or as we are abiding in Christ, we are abiding in that word, it brings about the will of God in our lives. It says, you can ask what you will. Now, we all know that's within the confines of the word of God. The word of God is the will of God. And when we are abiding in the word, when we are feeding on the word of God, and the word of God is dwelling in us, then we declare what the will of God is. Amen. And Jesus said it would be done unto us. And we understand Jesus told his disciples, pray that your daily bread would manifest. Give us this day our daily bread. And I know he was also talking about, you know, the food, you know, so they wouldn't be starving. But we also see in the word of God that Jesus called healing the power of God that quickens a man or a woman in their distressed state. The power of God that brings supernatural provision, amen, to humanity. Jesus said that that power of God is for the children, and it's called the children's bread. So today, be a partaker of the power of the word of God. Let your heart be boosted in the faith of the word of God. Hear the Spirit of God speak to your heart and declare to you that you are healed of any ailments, any type of sickness, disease, abnormalities, malfunction. It doesn't matter what it is to Jesus, because he has the answer. He has the cure for you and I. Also remember this, that we stand on the word of God for our daily bread, because we know that sickness and disease is of Satan. Now, over there in Luke chapter 13, verse 16, we remember this woman. She can't look up. She's bent over. And when Jesus goes about to heal her, yeah, there's a controversy in the synagogue. And this is what Jesus tells them. He says, and ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan hath bound, lo, these 18 years, be loose from this bond on the Sabbath day? Jesus tells the people in the synagogue, Satan has done this. The devil has done this. This is a work of Beelzebub. This is a work of the netherworld. This is a dark work. And why are you making a controversy of when this woman would be healed? She is a daughter of Abraham. She is a daughter of the covenant of Almighty God, which says, I will heal you. And he says, ought not this woman be healed, who Satan has bound, lo, these 18 years? And so we understand healing is our redemptive right. Healing is right for us. It is a part of our daily bread, because sickness and disease is of Satan. Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil, because God was with him. And so we understand, amen, it is the will of God. 1 John 3:8, for this purpose, the Son of God was manifest to destroy the works of the devil. Amen. And we understand that this work of sickness came when Adam sinned. You don't have to be in sin to be sick, because it is part of the fall. It is part of the degradation of humanity. But Jesus has the answer. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever, and he wants to heal you and make you whole. Remember, Hebrews 8:6 says, we have a better covenant based on better promises, and we understand in the Old Testament, there was still a healing cure. The Word of God says, there is a balm in Gilead. Amen. That was in the Old Testament. But we have a better covenant based on better promises. And if God healed them in the Old Testament, how much more does the Christ in you want to rise big in you, and out of your belly flow those healing rivers springing up into everlasting life? Let the Lord touch you tonight. Amen. Open up your Bible. Begin to feed on the Word of God. Remember, divine healing is a spiritual work. Jesus said in John 6:63, my word, the words that I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. Divine healing is a spiritual work. You begin to feed on the Word of God, and it begins to go into your reborn spirit. Amen. The Christ in you begins to minister to you. Amen. And as you hold fast the words of Almighty God, as you hold fast the words of the Anointed One, and that anointing will quicken your mortal body and make you every whit whole. This is Pastor James. Come on and receive your healing tonight. Father, I thank you for those who are listening right now, whether it be arthritis, diabetes, hypertension, cancers of every kind, leukemias. In the name of Jesus, I see someone with cataracts right now. Be free from that in the name of Jesus. Someone has a burning on their scalp. Something's happened with your scalp. There's a burning. There's some type of rash. We just receive that healing right now in the name of Jesus. There's a congenital heart disorder that someone's dealing with right now. You just receive it tonight. Receive it tonight as the spirit of the kidney disorder right now. Right now, receive that work of divine healing. It's yours. Just take it. Just take it. Jesus said, by my stripes you are healed. Take it. Receive it tonight. And then feed on the Word of God. Praise God. Amen. Keep it simple. Read your Bible and thank God that His Word is true. And stay with it. Stay with it until it gets in your heart. Amen. Many times we're reading it, but we don't read enough until it gets on the end. It's got to go through the solical parts into the heart. Amen. But the Word of God says the entrance of the Word of God brings life. When that Word touches your reborn spirit, when the Spirit begins to be enlightened by the Word, oh, there it is now. There it is. Amen. Weeping may endure for a night, but when the light comes, woo, there's joy. There's joy. There's joy for you. Amen. It's your morning time. Amen. So receive the Word of God with joy and gladness. Amen. Let God be true and everything else that would try to speak to you, amen, you see it as a lie. God wills for you to be healing. Receive your bread tonight, amen, and be blessed. Remember, we're on at 10:30 Sunday mornings, amen. Spirit Life broadcast is on 10:30 on Sunday mornings. We were on at 10, but now we're coming on by way of the internet and Facebook on 10:30 on Sunday mornings. So join in with us or come on over at 3401 Governor Prince Boulevard in Wilmington, Delaware. Amen. We'll make you feel at home. Amen. And come over and feast on the bread of the Word of God with us. Have a blessed evening. The Lord bless you and keep you safe. Amen. Amen.